It's been the dream in the minds of many, many people to associate the excitement of scents and olfaction and perfumes and with other elements from the entertaining world. And of course, for me as a perfumer, this is something also very exciting, and I hope to be able to bring much more of that with other operatic pieces or in the movie industry or any kind of entertainment, the ballet, the museums, etc. Because there is much, much, much to do, as much as what has been done so far with music, for instance, in those arenas. For the Saint Opera, there were two challenges. A creative challenge: you had to make fragrances that would be played at a very short, in a very short period of time. The fragrances have to be compatible with each other. One difference with visual clues, for instance, is that the molecules from the sense of smell, or naturals, it doesn't matter, but what you smell lingers in the nose longer than something lingers on your retina. So you, when you smell something, the impression that you get depends on what you've smelled just before. So in the Saint Opera, where people were smelling things as fast as every 6 seconds, you had to create smell number two, for instance, depending on what smell number one was, and depending also on what smell number three would be. And then smell number two would be played again later in the opera after smell number 16. So smell number two had to take into account also smell 16 to be perceived still as smell number two, etc. So there was this whole gymnastic of things. Also, people for the Saint Opera, people have smelled around 30 scents within 30 minutes. Creating 30 scents, it's a very different task from creating, usually you create one scent to put in one bottle or one scent to put in one shampoo. It's here, it's like a zoo, if you wish, of 30 animals all of a sudden that you have to manage, that you have to, number one, create and tame, and it's quite something creatively wise. The other challenge was the technology, and which was blocking the scent clues from the entertaining world till now. Because contamination is number one enemy. You don't want the cinema to smell like a soup after a while. You don't want that after the first performance, you don't want that everything is contaminated. So we had to have some very special equipment made. And so we work with the biggest ventilation company in the world for that. And they custom made something, a scent organ for us, in fact. I had to work in very close collaboration with them to almost invent every step along the way so that we could play all these scents and recognize them and keep them in the pure form and have several performances, one after the other, without problems. So it was quite something, but it worked, and hopefully now we're going to make many more. So we played it at the theater at the Guggenheim Museum here in New York, and every seat was equipped with what we call a scent microphone. That was actually the arrival of an individual tube. So the seats were not wired, they were tubed individually for every viewer or sniffer to be able to enjoy the scent opera. And the scent organ that we built with Flacked Woods and the company, it's like the, how shall I say, like Yamaha would build a very good pianos, I guess. Then you have Flacked Woods building some very special air managing equipment, very, very precise, to handle those scents so that they don't mix with each other, etc. And so the viewers would just sit in their seats and then enjoy the music and the scent coming at them, if you wish. And the challenge was to make sure that people would recognize the scent. It's very unusual. Right now, when you watch a movie, the musical clues, you know them because you've been educated with them. Why, when you hear these strings of the violin, you know that something bad is going to happen. It's not because you were born with this perception of the music, it's because you've learned it by watching over and over movies, and you associate now that violin kind of clang music with a bad moment. And now, even if you don't see the monster, you know the monster is in the room because those violins are starting playing that kind of music. Now, people don't have those clues yet in their memory about scent. So we had to play a little prelude where we describe the scent with the music and with some words, so that they started to make this association quite quickly. And thank God the brain is very used at associating an event with a scent. The brain is even better at doing that than at associating a visual clue with an event. You don't have to repeat as much. And so within 15 minutes, we gave already a few tips, I would say. And then people attended the opera in the dark and could really make the association between the scents coming and going and the musical clues, the music playing at the same time. So it was quite an exercise. But we could see, because the audience would laugh at the right moment, and then they would tell us afterwards, oh yeah, I could really see what was happening, the battle between technology and nature and metal coming in and all that kind of stuff, and then the weirdo passing by and making a chaos and all that. So people could really make a parallel with what they would have enjoyed in another arena.